Hi, good morning. I'm the co-founder of Vuster. We are a video-on-demand company, believe it or not, out of Switzerland. Normally, you would think skiing, pretty mountains, bank accounts that are not so secret anymore. But we're a technology company. We've been going for 5 years, team of 20. Switzerland's very expensive to establish a company, so we're spread out over locations. Development is in Romania and in the Ukraine. We have business development in the US and here in the UK. We are VC funded. We received funding at the worst possible time in 2008. So we heard yesterday that starting in a crisis is good, but it would finally be good also if the crisis were over, I guess. Very importantly, we're profitable. I'll talk about the product a little. We're cross-platform, so you can get us on a website, you can get us on connected TV, on tablets, on mobiles, and we've literally done deals with all the hardware manufacturers. We have 150 content suppliers, a lot of them out of Hollywood, and I'll tell you our story, how we found our niche, really. Like everyone, we launched with paid content, and then all the hardware manufacturers said, but your billing system is so terrible, you can't possibly be wanting to launch with that. And then we said, you know what, we guess they're right, and we did something radical. We paid some money to our content owners, and we said, just sit tight, we're gonna let everything go free, internet style. And we did that for 6 months, and we learned a whole lot of things during that period, and that's really when our business also took off. Here's the hardware manufacturer logo, so there's literally all the big guys on it. And when our business took off, we learned, for one, that we have a global business. If content is good, it will be watched in English. We're available in 10 languages. That's the UI of the site. We have a couple of big markets. They're US, UK, Australia, and Germany. And we've signed up a lot of ad networks. We've literally signed up 100 of them because we believe if they backfill each other, that's when we make the most money. So our business model is largely we let the content go out still free, but with video ads, monetized. And from there, we upsell now into paid transactions. So it's a hybrid business model. We get about 5 million unique users. Obviously, always a debate with Comscore whether their figures should not be closer to our Google Analytics figures, but that's the Comscore figure. And we send out more than 250 million video ads a month, which is on average, which is pretty substantial. Clearly Q4 is very, very good for us. And what's really exciting, and what has felt like the most amazing ride this year, is we have literally increased our turnover by a factor of 7 over last year. And through that, we've become not only profitable, but also a different company. And we're now thinking about which territories should we go for next. There's certainly LATAM on the map where we're starting now. That's looking great and building out a localized offering. There's also Southeast Asia. We're wanting to do the same, and the Arab region. And here's a couple of interesting facts. As we let all the content go out free, we learned that typically you would have said, if content is not in local language, say for France, for example, or for Spain, no one's gonna watch it. And we found out, so long as the content is really good or recognizable, people will still watch it, even if it's in English. Guess what, they probably do the same on the pirated platforms anyway. And then we also found there's never an even distribution. I mean, everyone talks about the media business being hit-driven. We find exactly the same, and I've taken an example here of a movie called Dirty Deeds that none of you will have heard of or have seen, but it made us a lot of money because somehow it captured the imagination of our users, and we keep finding these exceptions, and it's a bit like mining for diamonds. It's good to have these titles coming because they tend to be more profitable for us than the titles coming from the big movie studios. And everyone would typically also say that rights to free content are very difficult to source, that you would only get crappy free content, user-generated or how-to guides. Well, that's not true. We're finding that we're getting great content that we're able to monetize with video ads, and it's becoming a real business. And also what we found, there's a lot of talk about connected devices. That is still the smaller business model for us. We're seeing a lot of usage coming in via the web, followed by mobile, and connected TV is relatively small still, although the growth is good, but it comes off quite a low base. Next steps, very important for us. We need to get more social. If you think Facebook Connect, what that can do for us, we think it's, or we believe it's, the most powerful recommendation engine you can imagine, because not only can users see which movies their friends have liked, we can actively push movies to them in the categories that they're likely to be interested in. So that's a big one for us. And another big one, also in connection with Facebook, is we're launching you could say gamification of professional content, where users guess from single short scenes what the entire movie is, and from there we're bringing users onto our platform itself, and we think that's a lot more clever than spending money on Google AdWords, for example, because this can really propel an audience much higher. And if you think SongPop, I think they gained 24 million unique users. We believe this game can do a lot for us. And if you think that for next year, what are our plans? It's really the regional rollouts and keeping the momentum growing sevenfold over last year has really been amazing. And we're not sure we'll see years of that growth, but we're certainly trying to first of all manage the team to keep up with that growth, and secondly also to make sure that we stay as monetized as we are now and sold out with ads wherever we're available. Thank you.